there.
Your deeds have been nothing short of legendary. With the plain meld at an end, Tamriel may yet endure. Now the time has come to confront Molag Bal and reclaim your soul. You must lead the five companions into this final battle. We are all of us prepared to sacrifice our lives to see this through to the end. Our plan is to use the Amulet of Kings to invest you with the power to do battle with the Daedric Prince. No doubt the God of Schemes has rallied his most powerful servants to his side, but his arrogance has already proven to be his undoing. He may not even consider you a threat. We shall endeavor to prove him utterly, catastrophically wrong.
I'll never get used to this place. Come here, Vestige. I'd like a word before we skip off merrily to our doom. The time is at hand. Stop second-guessing yourself. Stop questioning your resolve. Just stand up and do it. You're ready. This is it. The beginning of the blasted end. There's no point in pretending this isn't happening or saying we're not ready. This challenge will not wait. Can you do what is necessary, no matter the cost? No matter how much it grieves you. There is always a choice, but you don't get to choose what is true. You only get to choose what you will do about it. Do you need a reminder about what lies ahead? We are approaching the fortress of Molag Bal, perhaps the most dangerous place in all of Oblivion. Together, we five are mighty. Even I will admit that. But I cannot invoke the ritual until we are in the presence of the Dark Prince himself. In exchange for this investiture of power, one of your companions will need to be sacrificed. It will be for you to decide which when the time comes. The infusion of power will not last for long. That's why we need to get close. And then what? I've no idea what will happen to you. Apotheosis? Disintegration? Too many unknowns and not enough information. But if you defeat Molag Bal and survive, your soul and the soul of every other surviving vestige should be restored.
This place is alive with pain and suffering. This must be where Molag Bal torments those who displease him.
Manimarco. my torment? Or is your appearance here a part of it? I am neither alive nor dead. I am trapped in a gout of ash and bile and swirling vapors. My ears are filled with the screams of 1,000 nails being drawn. And the pain is endless. I am his plaything, and an abject lesson to others who would thwart him. My plan was flawless. My machinations were executed to perfection. I would have been a god if not for you. My only consolation is that you will know this pain soon enough. Arrogant, presumptuous, egotistical twaddle. That bit of costume jewelry is nothing compared to the master's power. I expect I'll be seeing you soon. My only joy for the rest. After all that's transpired, I killed you, you simpleton. I saw your life gutter and fade like a candle flame in a tempest. My undead servants drank your blood, and I reanimated your corpse. Do not taunt me with
Manimarco. He was a backstabbing hypocrite with delusions of godhood. The fool got precisely what he deserved.